Tonight on NewsWatch, what did they know and when did they know it? New reports claim U.S. government officials were aware of the possibility of the deadly embassy attack. We'll have the latest.
Plus, waging a war on women. Many Democrats say Republicans are against those voters, but is that actually the view of women?
And running for hope. How one man went from the front lines of civil war to crossing the finish line of a marathon. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. A fourth day of protest leads to more destruction. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. U.S. diplomatic missions in North Africa and the Middle East are on high alert tonight. Violence over an anti-Muslim film produced in the U.S. continues to spread. More than 10 countries are now joining the protests. Radical Muslims are rioting at embassies and consulates, even fast food restaurants like KFC and Arby's. Mark Martin has tonight's top story.
Police in riot gear launched tear gas into the crowd of protesters in Cairo to keep crowds away from the U.S. Embassy compound. This new vigilance comes after a reportedly blunt conversation between President Obama and the Egyptian president.
I don't think that we would consider them an ally, but we don't consider them an enemy.
The demonstrations are allegedly fueled by an amateur film called Innocence of Muslims. Many here say the movie is blasphemous, denigrating the Prophet Muhammad.
My message is, do not come near to us. Stop. Stop disrespecting us.
Back in the U.S., police and reporters surrounded the home of the man who allegedly produced the film. Police say a 55-year-old Egyptian Christian, Nakula Basli Nakula, made and promoted the movie. In Libya, the parliamentary president laid a wreath at the U.S. consulate in Benghazi, where four Americans were killed, including U.S. Ambassador Chris Stevens, in an attack apparently designed to strike on 9/11.
Definitely, it was a deliberate and pre-planned attack in every sense of the word.
We were not aware of any actionable intelligence indicating that an attack on the U.S. mission in Benghazi was planned or imminent.
Meanwhile, the FBI warned today the anger over that anti-Muslim movie could spread to the U.S. The bulletin says extremist groups in the U.S. may use the opportunity to, quote, exploit anger over the film to advance their recruitment efforts. Mark Martin, CBN News.
But still, many are wondering what warnings the U.S. had before the attack in Libya that left the American ambassador and three others dead. Despite what Jay Carney said in that briefing, according to a report in the British newspaper The Independent, the State Department had credible information of the attack a whole 48 hours before it took place. But even with that warning, there was no instruction for diplomats to be on alert.
We did evaluate the threat stream. And we determined that the security at Benghazi was appropriate for what we knew.
Also, our terrorism analyst at CBN News, Eric Stackelbeck, made this point about al-Qaeda's leader, Ayman al-Zawahiri.
So one day before this storming of the embassy in Libya, Zawahiri releases a tape calling for vengeance, calling for Libyan jihadists to rise up. That's exactly what happens.
Eric is always working to bring you the latest news on terrorism around the world. To stay up to date, make sure you check out his blog and his weekly program, Stackelback on Terror. You can find it both at cbnnews.com.
President Obama spent the afternoon at Andrews Air Force Base. The president, along with Vice President Biden and Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, were on hand as the bodies of Ambassador Chris Stevens and the three other Americans killed in Libya returned home. The president also spent time visiting with the families of the victims. Meanwhile, the Republican candidate for vice president says unsteady U.S. leadership is partly to blame for the crisis across the Middle East and North Africa. At the Values Voter Summit in Washington, Paul Ryan pointed out all the worsening woes in the region.
The slaughter of brave dissidents in Syria, mobs storming American embassies and consulates, Iran 4 years closer to gaining a nuclear weapon. Israel, our best ally in the region, treated with indifference bordering on contempt by the Obama administration.
Ryan went on to say moral clarity and competent use of U.S. influence will overcome evil and violence in that region.
Democrats want voters to believe that Republicans are waging a war on women. The media have picked up on that argument. The question is, are women buying it? As Paul Strand reports tonight, it depends on the women you ask.
Spoke with his characteristic One candor. Tactic Democrats use to bolster belief leadership? That the Romney-Ryan ticket is engaged in a war on women is pointing out the Republicans' plan to repeal Obamacare.
It includes preventive care. It includes pregnancy, coverage during pregnancy. Those issues are really important to women. Women need that coverage.
But there are others, like those on this bus, who say women concerned about health care should not fear the Romney-Ryan ticket, especially those who believe abortion is not health care.
For weeks now, this bus filled with pro-life women has been crisscrossing the country, opposing the man they call the most pro-abortion president in history. We caught up with them in Orlando. They charge if there's a war on women, it's Barack Obama who's leading that fight.
There's never been a pro-life bill that he liked or a pro-abortion bill that he didn't like.
And they believe a second Obama term will mean taxpayer-funded abortions nationwide. On the flip side, pro-abortion advocates, like many seen at the Democratic convention, have dark warnings about a Romney presidency.
He would overturn Roe versus Wade and sign into law a wave of outrageous restrictions on a woman's ability to make decisions about her pregnancy.
These days, that even seems to mean the so-called right to free contraception. Dr. Jan Krause of Concerned Women for America.
The whole idea that you and I as taxpayers have to fund college kids' contraception? Come on, give me a break. There's a drugstore on practically every corner.
And what has such unlimited access to contraception and abortion brought the women of America?
1.2 million abortions a year. It's a false security that contraceptives provide, but also it isn't health care. It isn't health care to offer women, you know, the opportunity to kill their own babies.
Wisconsin Lieutenant Governor Rebecca Clayfish believes most women don't agree that opposing abortion equals a war against them.
I think you would be very surprised at how few women put free abortions and government paid for birth control at the top of their priority list.
New polling this year provides some evidence to the point.
41% of America said that they were pro-choice, which is the lowest in recorded history.
Dr. Krause says it's just not an issue for most women.
Their concerns aren't there. Their concerns are about the future stability of this country.
But that's why Democrat Liz Rose says her friends fear Romney, the economic future.
My friends really care about the economic, the kitchen table economic issues. You know, we want our kids to be better off than we are.
Funny, because that's one of the main reasons Krause says her friends fear Obama.
They're concerned about the economics, the fiscal crisis, the debt burden that we're passing along to our children.
So there it is. There are those who feel the Republicans are waging a war on women, while others feel they're waging a war for women.
The issue's so hot, you could almost say it's causing a war between women. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Orlando, Florida.
Thanks, Paul. The National Organization for Marriage says it's making progress in New York. It helped unseat two incumbent senators in the state special election this week. Another nom candidate is expected to win a tight race once the votes are finalized. Two other incumbents were defeated earlier in primaries. Nom President Brian Brown says the message from the people of New York is clear. Quote, they will not tolerate politicians, Democrat or Republican, who redefine marriage. Brown says they targeted six lawmakers who turned on traditional marriage, and they won't stop until the final two are unseated.
State lawmakers in Missouri have passed a law protecting businesses that refuse to provide birth control in their health insurance plans. The votes in both houses of the state legislature there were overwhelming and enough to override the governor's threatened veto. Missouri is the first state to pass a measure that rejects President Obama's contraception mandate on religious grounds. The Missouri Catholic Conference, Missouri Right to Life, and other anti-abortion groups championed that measure.
Coming up, an uptick in tourism. How Brazil is aiding the American economy.
A decorated veteran.
I love my country, and I love being free.
Discovers his greatest battle.
I kept thinking about my son.
Is much closer to home.
You are breaking the law. That is a lie, and you know it.
Now, it's time to take a stand.
The drama just continues to unfold here.
And become a hero all over again.
We fight for freedom.
Last ounce of courage.
It's freedom.
Now playing at select theaters.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker diabetes cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
A decorated veteran.
I love my country, and I love being free.
Discovers his greatest battle.
I kept thinking about my son.
Is much closer to home.
You are breaking the law.
That is a lie, and you know it.
Now, it's time to take a stand.
The drama just continues to unfold here.
And become a hero all over again.
We fight for freedom!
Last Ounce of Courage.
This is freedom.
Now playing at select theaters.
Well, get ready to pay more for the price of a plane ticket. Seven major airlines have plans to raise ticket fares. Southwest began the move by announcing a $10 increase on about 10% of its flights. American, Delta, U.S. Airways, JetBlue, and Virgin America all followed suit. United Airlines went one step further. Their price increase will cover the majority of domestic flights. Well, those price increases come as the U.S. economy remains weak, but it could get some help from a source you might not expect.
Yeah, after 9/11, America made it harder for foreigners to visit this country. Now the U.S. sees those same visitors as an economic stimulus rather than a security threat.
And as Heather Sells explains, Brazil is a lucrative source of tourist money.
Millions around the world see the United States as their number one travel destination. Daniel Cabral is one of them. Although he lives along the beautiful Brazilian coast, he looks for opportunities to visit the States.
It's really good for us Brazilians to go shopping in the States because the prices there compared to here, buying here, are really low.
In fact, foreign visitors represent big money. Last year, they spent $150 billion here, and Brazilians topped the charts, spending around $5,000 per visit.
The fact is Brazilians, especially the newly rich Brazilians up here in the Northeast, they have opportunities and money to spend, and they want to see the world. They want to see America.
But it's not all good news.
The value of global travel is expected to double in the next 10 years to over $2 trillion. But the U.S. share of that is shrinking. That's why many are asking the government to ease travel restrictions.
People like to use services that are easy and convenient.
Security analyst James Carafano says a laborious visa process hurts foreign tourism. It stems in part from 9/11. In fact, the travel industry calls the last 10 years the lost decade. In 2000, the U.S. commanded 17% of the world's international travel. Today, it's just 12%. A big reason for that drop is that many potential tourists need a passport plus a visa to travel to the U.S. And getting that visa can take months.
You have to go through a lengthy application process and also have an in-person interview with a consular officer in order to be approved for a visa.
CBN News met Bruno Teixeira as he waited for his outside the U.S. consulate in Recife, Brazil.
Because my city, I can't take the visa there. So I got to travel to here and spend 2 days here.
What we've seen with some Brazilian tourists is they're actually going to countries where they don't have to get a visa, countries like France, countries like Germany.
At Disney World in January, the president announced that the U.S. will cut visa wait times in Brazil and China by 40% in the next year. And thanks to extra staff, it's already happening. In Recife, it used to take 60 days to get a visa. It now takes 2. There's also support to add more countries, such as Brazil, to the visa waiver program. This allows travelers to come to the U.S. with just their passport.
Well, I think the number one thing the United States can do is make it easier to travel to the United States. Now, in a post 9/11 world, people confuse easy with more security risks, but that's not necessarily so.
Carafano and others maintain travelers from visa waiver countries are less of a risk. That's because those countries must agree to specific security protocols, share lost and stolen passport information, and have a low visa refusal rate to begin with.
The U.S. government knows more information about somebody coming from a country where you don't have to get a visa, ironically, than a country where you do.
For Daniel Cabral, these efforts are already paying off. It took just 2 weeks for him to get a visa for a visit in May.
I told my friends, all my friends, about my experience. They are all trying. Even my family, they're getting their visas now because of the facilities.
Bringing in tourists becomes a greater priority with the current unemployment rate. That's because every 33 visitors here create one American job. So the more people who visit, the more Americans will get back to work. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Up next, transformation in war. How one man found God in the midst of fighting in Lebanon.
News.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
A decorated veteran.
I love my country, and I love being free.
Discovers his greatest battle.
I kept thinking about my son.
Is much closer to home.
You are breaking the law.
That is a lie, and you know it.
Now, it's time to take a stand.
The drama just continues to unfold here.
And become a hero all over again.
We fight for freedom!
Last Ounce of Courage.
It's freedom.
Now playing at select theaters.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
A decorated veteran.
I love my country, and I love being free.
Discovers his greatest battle.
I kept thinking about my son.
Is much closer to home.
You are breaking the law.
That is a lie, and you know it.
Now, it's time to take a stand.
The drama just continues to unfold here.
And become a hero all over again.
We fight for freedom!
Last Ounce of Courage.
It's freedom.
Now playing at select theaters.
Today marks the start of the Pope's three-day visit to Lebanon. Pope Benedict describes his trip as a pilgrimage of peace. Lebanon has the largest percentage of Christians anywhere in the Middle East. The Vatican says this trip is especially important now in the wake of the killing of the U.S. Ambassador Chris Stevens in Libya and the brutal civil war in Syria. And Pope Benedict's visit to Lebanon comes at a tough time because of the fighting in neighboring Syria.
Yeah, the people of Lebanon face almost constant conflict, but God still moves in this troubled nation. Gary Lane shows us how one soldier's life was transformed during Lebanon's civil war.
Lebanese-American Eli Hisbani never dreamed he'd live in Milwaukee, and he never imagined he'd be running a marathon.
My main inspiration is Jesus. That's why I'm doing this, because of him and because he changed my life.
His life journey began half a world away in Lebanon.
It's a beautiful country. It's mentioned in the Bible many times. And the cedar of Lebanon, gorgeous. And this country is really in my heart.
Raised in a Christian culture, he grew up peacefully with his Muslim neighbors.
These people, they were my, the children were my best friend. We just love to be together and have fun.
Some were Palestinian, not Lebanese.
Palestinians came to our country as refugees. We hosted them, we liked them, we sympathized with them, and now they turn against us, and they want to kill us.
Civil war broke out in 1975 when the Palestinian Liberation Organization and its Muslim backers attacked Israel and Christian villages in Lebanon. Eli joined the Israeli-supported SLA, South Lebanon Army.
I want to protect my family. I want to protect my identity as a Lebanese or as a Christian at that time, and the people of my country.
The Lebanese civil war took its toll, surrounding him with death and destruction.
You don't know if you will die today or tomorrow. So I start hating myself, not only hating my enemy. So I start drinking to forget. I didn't care about life. I didn't care about if I will die or live.
Eli's thinking changed quickly after his commander ordered him to disarm enemy rockets. That's when a landmine exploded beneath his feet.
I start thinking, I'm gonna die. How can I face God right now? He's going to judge me. I was so afraid. Jesus, if you are alive, save me. I don't want to go to hell.
Eli's life was spared. He lost his left leg, but gained salvation. Called to ministry, he eventually joined Youth with a Mission and later attended the Arab Baptist Seminary.
And it was right here in Beirut where Eli studied and he first preached that he learned that it was no longer safe for him to remain in Lebanon. So he packed up his family and he left the country of his birth and headed for America.
He now serves as Nations Pastor at Milwaukee's Eastbrook Church, home to Christians from 16 countries.
Trying to equip the church, help the church understand more how to work cross-culturally, how to love people from different countries around.
Eli says God gave him a vision to do something bigger, to share his heart for the nations, not only with the people of Eastbrook Church, but with the entire Milwaukee community.
Each year, he sponsors and participates in a charitable marathon race called Running for Hope. The idea came as Eli played soccer with his sons.
Why I don't run? I don't, you know, why I don't start an organization called Running, but for Hope. And do this the fundraising and send ship container of wheelchairs, crutches, walkers.
CBN News talked with some of this year's participants.
I run with Eli because he's so inspirational. He runs with one leg, and if I have two, I feel like I can help him out and help his cause. And it's called Running for Hope, and I feel like we give hope to a lot of people.
Eli hopes to return to Lebanon someday to personally deliver wheelchairs and other help. That's unlikely to happen as long as the militant Islamic group Hezbollah dominates the country.
I want to offer something for them. I want to share my story. Because these people need God more than any. Because we had war. These people are broken, suffering. They are still suffering. And there's a lot of hate, enmity, and people revenge. And we need God.
In the meantime, Eli says he'll continue the annual marathon. He also wants to encourage others to win life's spiritual race.
You have to have insurance and have this relationship with Christ in order to win the race. He was there for me when I was dying on the ground. And I knew that in heaven, now my leg will come back. And not only I have eternal life, I will have a new body. And I can run, and I can fly. I can enjoy this body. That's my hope.
Gary Lane, CBN News, Milwaukee.
Wow, he's sprinting. Well, up next, an unlikely duet and neighborhood practices bringing in the Jewish New Year, but you've got to see it to believe it.
CBNNews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
A decorated veteran.
I love my country, and I love being free.
Discovers his greatest battle.
I kept thinking about my son.
Is much closer to home.
You are breaking the law.
That is a lie, and you know it.
Now, it's time to take a stand.
The drama just continues to unfold here.
And become a hero all over again.
We fight for freedom!
Last Ounce of Courage.
This is freedom.
Now playing at select theaters.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
A decorated veteran.
I love my country, and I love being free.
Discovers his greatest battle.
I kept thinking about my son.
Is much closer to home.
You are breaking the law.
That is a lie, and you know it.
Now, it's time to take a stand.
The drama just continues to unfold here.
And become a hero all over again.
We fight for freedom!
Last Ounce of Courage.
This is freedom.
Now playing at select theaters.
Well, the Jewish New Year, also known as Rosh Hashanah, begins at sundown on Sunday.
And in the spirit of Rosh Hashanah, a rabbi in Utah decided to demonstrate the shofar. That, of course, is the horn used in synagogue services to announce holidays. But unexpectedly, his performance became a duet. Take a look. That's great.
Wonder where that dog came from. He just sort of like came up and started. He was pretty good. He was on key.
It was great.
Well, that's going to do it for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for watching. Have a great weekend. We'll see you Monday.